Hi, everybody, and welcome back. It's time now to go to the paddock. In the dark, dingy place, the paddock. And the paddock judge, Sonny, and always an interesting segment. Today, Sonny's going to be talking about earplugs, and I'll bet you didn't know a lot of things about them. Let's watch.
Thanks, guys. Today, we're here with driver Michael Simon. We're going to take a look at the earplugs, how he puts them in, why, and what they're used for. Mike, tell us a little bit about that.
Oh, well, these are pull-out earplugs, and you use them basically, to the human, to have these in would be like a set of headphones. You put these in their ears, and they calm down. It'll help them calm down from the loud noises, perhaps a horse coming up behind them. You need to conserve their energy for the 6-7 minutes you're out there before the race starts. So what we do is there's either sponges or these rubber pieces here. They're attached to a string. We'll put them, this will go right over, the bridle will be on the horse, and we'll put them in. I'll run this string back to the back through the harness and to the stirrup on the bike. And then at some point in time during the race, like if you feel the horse letting go a little bit, maybe getting a little tired, what you'd like to think is if you pulled this, you jerked the string out, you pulled this out, hopefully the horse will shift gears and it'll go on a little further for you, a little faster. But you see these probably on 3 out of every 4 horses in the race nowadays. And basically what it is to do is just keep the horse calm.
There you have it. Thanks, Mike. Back to you. I'm Sonny, the paddock judge.
Good job, Sonny. Now let's go to Harris Fifth on Monday. Real Class had the rail and was the even money favorite. PH Top Dog was the 3-1 second choice. Gotta serve somebody. I love that name. Was the 7-2 third choice. Here's the call with James.
It's PH Top Dog by just 3 parts of a length. Diamond Dan is a closer second from first over. Gotta Serve Somebody is locked in the box. Real Class is second over and 2 lengths from the lead. Lightning Jack's back angles 3 wide midway up the backstretch. Radar Installed has no room. Bucktown Bad Boy has some 4.5 to make up. And Richard Henry is last through 3/4 in 1:24.3. They're midway around the far turn, and it's PH Top Dog by just 0.5 length. Real Class is out 3 wide now. Diamond Dan has asked for more from between rivals. Gotta Serve Somebody awaits the open stretch. Radar Installed needs racing room, and widest of all is Lightning Jack's back. They're at the top of the stretch, and it's PH Top Dog hanging on by 3 parts of a length. Gotta Serve Somebody at the inside. Real Class, widest of all is Lightning Jack's back.
Lightning Jack's back came from Yanemsville to win in 153 flat for Tim Curtin. No, not the guy from the Rocky Horror Picture Show. This is a different Tim Curtin. Anyway,
oh, I know that movie.
Season 3
ending.
Used to get dressed up on a Friday night and watch the fucker at midnight. PH Top Dog for Grismore was second. 28-1 bomb. Radar Installed with Daryl Beer was third. And that's the result. Now it's time to go to Harris Monday, the 11th race. And with that, here's Heather.
Yep, that's me. Winfield Flash is your race favorite, and he's coming off a win. Also, we've got Frog Juice. Love the name.
Who?
Frog Juice. Ribbit. He's been racing on Harrington's half mile recently. And Devil's Ivy, look out for this one, going to post for trainer Artie Foster.
Beware of the Frog Juice. Let's watch.
Devil's Ivy is urged on first over, and Point of Attack makes a 3 wide move midway up the backstretch. Western Number is in behind a crowd. Frog Juice is drawn within 3 lengths of the leader, and it's 2.5 more to Real One and Only, and Rocco's Rocket is last as they approach 3/4. Winfield Flash is under pressure from Devil's Ivy, and Point of Attack makes it a line of 3/4 in 1:24. They come to the top of the stretch, and it's Winfield Flash hanging tough by a neck. Devil's Ivy, Point of Attack, widest of all is Frog Juice. These four all with a good shot. LeBron waits for the open stretch. 1:50 to go, and it's Winfield Flash by a head. Devil's Ivy, center of the track is Frog Juice. In the final strides, Winfield Flash, Frog Juice.
Frog Juice and driver George Napolitano Jr. had the 3-hole, but they ended up getting away in the back of the pack, but they made up ground with a last quarter of 27-3. They went in 1:52-1. Now, the owners and breeders of Frog Juice are Gary and Barbara Isles. Gary is a barber. All the horses that they breed are named after, like, hair things, okay? So Frog Juice
is a hair thing?
Yep. Frog Juice's mother is named Hair She Goes. Now, Frog Juice, the reason for this horse's name is when kids come into Gary's barber shop, he tells the kids he's putting Frog Juice in their hair. It makes them smell good and makes them look good. I didn't make this up. I swear.
Is it dangerous for a driver to be driving a horse named Frog Juice? Does it get sloppy and messy and gritty?
No, I think it's all good, right?
It's all good, I guess. Okay.
Talk about driving Frog Juice. We're going to talk to the driver, George Napolitano Jr.
Excellent. And stay with us when we come back. We're going to have more action from Harris Chester right here. And also coming up is our blast from the past. Stay with us.
Sue is the paparazzo of the group. She's the one that takes the photos of the things you want to remember and a few things you don't. Everyone plays a part at Harris.
Only 10 minutes south of the Philadelphia airport,